Well, they getting crazy with these.
That weed so motherfucking good.
It actually smell like some shit you clean your house with.
Hey, that weed so motherfucking good. Hello, hello. 1, 2, hello, hello. Trey and Lee on the beat.
Okay.
Trey and Lee on the beat.
Okay, coming down. Brand new shoes.
Come on.
Carlos Miller.
Say what?
Interviews.
Interviews.
Pay my dues.
Pay your dues.
I can't lose.
Nah.
Try to play me. I refuse.
Back me up. Nah, matter of fact, I can do it myself, cause I'm parking on the self-parking. Okay. I hit the left and then the right and then the steering wheel signal. Just to know that I'm original. Coming through crispy. Nigga, can you hear me? Say the words like a nigga coming through. Hey, stop it one more time, then bring it back. We used to sell smack, no, we didn't do that. Matter of fact, we was outside while they was doing it, watching them take their lives and then ruin it. Hey, we had dreams and we came out on the other side. We flipped the script every time that it's time to ride. Hey. I wasn't even there that time when niggas got to tripping and pulled out them nines, but I heard about it. Cause you told me.
Yeah.
But that was in my old life, the old me. But ain't no OG, just the G for a long time. Just because your G ain't like mine. I been had my G since like 99, or maybe 89, or maybe 79.
What?
That's probably when I started formulating. They ain't gonna get it cause these niggas just be hating. It took a little while, a little waiting, but be patient. Come on, nigga. You know how I do. I keep a rhyme on deck, or maybe I'm gonna keep two. But when it comes to rhyming, I ain't fucking with you. Cause when I got nothing to do, I be listening to you.
Ooh.
Now that you know. Welcome back, bitch, to the 85 South Show.
Oh,
you already
man.
Know Black Excellence Spotlight. Bruh, it's time on. For you to get your excellence on.
Wow.
You're a very excellent, extraordinary, you know, hyperbolic, symbolic, mystic, chivalrous, respectable, commendable, most diabolical motherfucker. Never come out of Alabama, my man Trans Lee.
Amen. Appreciate it.
Trans Lee. Dope MC.
Appreciate
visionary.
It,
humanitarian,
hey.
Recycler, water
man,
drinker.
Come on, man.
Man of the earth, man of the turf.
Yeah,
how you living? Welcome back to the trap.
I did just finish drinking one of those Just Waters.
You want another one?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely
got shit
all
on
the
deck,
water.
Bro. I drink. Oh, got Capri, man.
Man, y'all yourself. Got it on deck, man.
You're not
y'all
a visitor drink, at this
oh,
point.
Oh, Capri Sun, okay.
Come on, man. Live your life.
Okay, yeah.
How you doing?
I'm good, man.
You
good.
Started a new brand.
Yeah, man. Yeah, it's been a long time coming, man. It's been a long time coming.
But I've been told you that.
Right, man. We done had several conversations, man. And you know, me being a rap artist, you know, sometimes, you know, I be in my head. And just even being in this business, man, like, you can really get in your head a whole lot, you know.
Yeah.
Because a whole lot of times there's more, like, failure than it is success, you know, especially when it's coming up. So that
can take
a toll on people, yeah. So, you know, I'm just here now as somebody who's kind of made it to the other side. Like, you know, like, it's really not that much pressure on life at all. Like, let's just be ourselves and, you know, try to find that inner peace so we can have that outer glow. And then that prompted me to start the brand. So here we are.
Here we are. Too. I'm keeping some of this shit.
That's your hoodie in the middle.
All right, bet.
Yeah.
So, inner peace.
Mm-hmm.
How did you find it?
Well, so that's the thing. It's a constant journey, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think that you can find it and then keep it for like the rest of your life, you know what I mean? But it's just being cognizant of, you know, if you're not in that space, to always be kind of seeking it, because that way, you know, you'll let a lot of things go. Like, you know, it's simple things like road rage, you know what I mean? Like, that things can get you upset and just off your game, somebody cutting you off. And that comes from a deeper space in you that, you know, if you just don't have that inner peace, it's just like whatever, you know what I mean? So
it's just
like simple things in life that can change the course of your day, you know, and it's like once you find that inner peace, you know, you can, you know, live
prosper.
Better. Yeah.
Level up.
Yeah.
Get to the bag. All that shit that people really want to do. You know, exactly. That's what I'm trying to do anyway.
Exactly.
Prosper.
Exactly.
Level up.
That's all.
Get to the bag.
Try to
inner peace. Out of glow.
You sound like a real preacher, bro.
Bro, y'all gonna stop
you
trying.
Really are,
me. Y'all gonna stop.
You right, really
trying
are.
Me, bro.
You done sat, but you from Mississippi though. You done sat in enough
that's
churches.
That's enough credentials right there.
Yeah, you done sat in enough churches to you could definitely be a preacher.
Come on, man.
But yeah, man, and it's been doing very well, man. Shout out my partner, Life Journey. I started the brand with him just to kind of partner and just to kind of get into the game, and we did pretty well, man. So now it's innerpeaceoutofglow.com, and you can get it. And we're also dropping a lot of content too, just to, you know, about
what kind of content?
Just really people's different journeys to how they found inner peace, and you know, like what things that they do to help them find it.
I smoke weed to find mine.
Exactly, that's what a lot of people do.
Yeah, I smoke.
That's
weed.
Definitely what I do. And I think that can help a lot of people. So we're definitely dropping those interviews, and then just a lot of more dazzling content.
Dazzling.
Coming soon, yeah.
Like visually stimulating.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, bet. You dropping any videos?
For the brand or for my?
For your music.
Yeah, so that's on the way too, man. That's what, you know, that's really, I'm like super excited because I finally got the album done and to a place where it's like I can now feel comfortable to say like, yo, it's really coming, it's really like a piece, you know what I mean? So we just tying up a little bit of the loose ends right now, and yeah, so sat down with Tip the other day and played it for him, and he was like,
you in that zone?
Yeah, so.
Why are you talking that shit every time you spit that shit, bro?
Man, it's really about just being vivid, man, because you know, like Andre 3000, one of my favorite artists, and I just always look at and break down how he sits you right in the seat next to him, you know what
right.
I mean? Like when you listening to it, and it's like I strive to be that type of artist. So, you know, I feel like I'm kind of getting more and more in that space, you know what I mean?
Most definitely.
Yeah, most definitely. Speaking of most dead, people try to compare me to him too.
He dope.
Yeah, he is dope, but you know, I get a lot of different comparisons.
That nigga dope, bro.
Yeah.
This is for the murderers and gamblers and dirty money handlers and people going to fuck off.
Yeah, nah, most definitely. I actually opened up for him a couple of years ago.
See?
Yeah.
He's got some shit to say.
Mm-hmm. Bro, I ain't had a Capri Sun in a long time, bro.
That's why you need to come through the trap more often, because we keep him on deck, bro.
And then
drinking Capri Suns help us find our inner peace.
This the place where you hear smoking on hay in the middle of the barn.
Yeah.
You don't hear that in many places, bro. I said that over there. I was like, man, you don't hear this many places. Joe was like, you need to hang around Cooler Circle, bro.
I'm like, the crazy part is all these niggas was lame until they started hanging with me.
For real? Nah, man.
Sprinkle sauce on all them niggas,
you gotta throw a little bit on
whole
like,
team swag the fuck
I know,
out
I know, Ryan. Y'all say Ryan.
J-O-N had all gospel music on his computer.
Oh, man.
I put him
straight
up
Kirk.
On all the thug shit.
Straight Kirk Franklin.
Not looking at. Look at him. Running an empire.
Got all black on brands on.
But you know what? You know what the big thing is? White people ain't supporting black owned business, man. We've been supporting their shit. They ain't spending no money in the black community.
You right. That's facts.
Somebody gonna fuck with us though.
So any white people that's watching this right now, innerpeaceoutofglow.com, you can put your money where your mouth is.
Yeah, and you can lie and tell your friends you got it from J. Crew. Whatever you gotta do to feel better about yourself.
Yeah. I'll do a partnership with Lululemon if I have to.
You should. You need to be open to opportunities.
Yeah, for sure.
Because, you know, we just got to speak them. Lululemon might hear this and reach out. Hey, yeah. Trans Lee, we really love your music. Somebody over there.
You know what's crazy? We've actually already done a partnership. Shout out to Gray in the building. My boy Gray in the building.
Hey, man.
Plant-based dripping, we actually did, he did a whole partnership with them a couple years ago for the vegan Thanksgiving. So they're already in the space of, like, supporting.
Because he do cool shit, too. Yeah. And then he'll jump in the Crown Vic.
Right.
And right, 38 are the hottest bars.
Bars ever, bro. Like, if I tell him all the time.
Sing two hooks.
Like, bro, you just like, the beat, you just fluid on the beats, bro, man.
Yeah.
Like,
psh, just and come the shit like believable.
That. Exactly, because it's true.
It's real life.
Yeah.
But he can get, hey, man, he can talk some bullshit on there, too, if he wants to.
Yeah.
Because he's earned his right to do that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just got to rap some shit just to let motherfuckers know you can rap.
Yeah, and he like going to make it sound good.
Some extravagant shit.
So. I was up at the office, man, and I heard a song that you did.
What song? I was high.
I don't know.
What song was it?
I don't know if we allowed to talk about that.
Who gonna stop me? When you seen a nigga stop me from doing anything?
It was fire, though. It was fire.
I just be fucking around. I let this shit. After I heard you, I was like, I'm just gonna chill.
It was fire.
Do this comedy, bro.
Folks don't know, we go back, too, man, because we shot... I'm in a like a little movie. I ain't gonna tell y'all what it's called because it's super lame. But
is it?
Is it?
You ain't gonna call them niggas movie lame.
No. I was with Bray earlier, so nah. I'm not saying that the role I was playing was super lame.
Really there you go. Super lame. That's
so,
better cleaning.
So up. I don't want to be sending y'all to it. But that's where I first met Los, man. That was probably about what? That may have been like 8-9 years ago.
Yeah, I had about two lines, but my two lines was.
It was killing. You said it's a free lunch kid.
Yeah.
That was his line because they was throwing the kids was throwing the food and he was like, it's them free lunch kids.
I'm gonna go ahead and
two
say
lines, bro.
Don't stop inviting me to shit if you really ain't got shit for me to do. I don't. Every time they got a project and it's the last 2 days, they want to call me. If you're not calling me in the beginning and letting me kick my shit,
but now,
don't
but,
give me no little ass.
But they doubled. But they doubled them over though.
That's what I'm saying. I didn't put in. I didn't gave them way too much.
We went to the premiere. He had to do stand up at the premiere.
I ain't have to do shit.
Well, nah, I mean, he didn't have to
do shit.
But you did.
They really was needing me at this point.
Yeah, man. But that's when I first really got on to your comedy, bro, because I was dying laughing in the crowd, like, bro, this nigga funny as hell. And yeah, man, I've been following you ever since.
Well, I appreciate that, you know. But yeah, they threw it just to give me the little shit to do.
Yeah, man.
Because I'm, you know, I'm better than some little shit. Put me in the whole fucking movie.
Right.
You can cut my shit out at the end, if, you know, the car chasing and shit. But still cut back to some of my shit. Yeah, I need to speak that shit, because the people who watching this to be like,
we didn't know you were ready for more shit, Carlos. We're sorry. We got six lines for you. We're going to cut two of those, and you have four.
You got to let them know, man.
It's whatever. Trying to be the first black Joker in this bitch.
You can't let them nav you, man.
Why you bring that up?
That's my dog, though.
But you know, they ain't even tell Eddie Murphy about me.
For real?
Shot a whole movie with him. Didn't even wear his hoodie down there or nothing.
Damn. Shout out Nav Green, though, man.
Hey, man. You shot him out. I ain't doing that. He know what he did.
Mm.
He know exactly what he did.
Yeah.
It was on purpose.
Damn, bro. If I was around 80, man, I would definitely tell him.
You would have told him?
Yeah. Bro, you are my top five comedians, bro.
Oh, appreciate that.
For real.
Man. I appreciate top five, that. Bro. Thanks, man. You know. It's been a long journey, Trans Lee.
Hey, man.
I've seen the game change multiple times.
You know? It's gonna keep on changing, man. But laughing is always relevant. You know what I mean? Like, ain't nothing more relevant. You know?
Yeah, man. People they criticize comedy so much. But I thought the whole goal was just to create laughter.
But y'all have the longest leash of anybody that can say anything. It's like, oh, okay.
What makes you? No, I don't think that.
I don't
I
mean
think
leash,
rappers got to they say whatever and they still be cool.
Yeah, that's true.
Some of our favorite lyrics are the most disrespectful shit you could ever think of.
That's a fact. And yeah, and there are habits of rappers say some things that like, what?
Yeah. Some real fucked up shit. But you know, fuck criticism.
It is what it is.
That's life. Yeah. Don't let it fuck up your inner peace.
Keep chasing that inner peace, and then really, you know, it's that's what's gonna give you the outer glow. Cause it's so many people that people find attractive just because they glowing so much from having that inner peace. They just like it's just oozing out of them, and it's like versus some people that the world may consider attractive, but they're so. They don't have it, and it's like, it's just something about it that's just not there. So, you know, it's just all about, no matter what you look like, if you have that inner peace, you will have that outer glow. So that's really the premise of the brand, and we just want to help people, you know, like, while we're here on this earth, the time that we have, let's do a little bit to push things forward, you know, because we don't
know. I-P-O-G?
I-Paul. that's what's in the...
That's a dope bucket, man. Where can they find it at?
So the buckets, man, the buckets aren't even out yet, man.
See, you can't be out here stunning on exclusive shit.
Yeah.
And then people gonna be trying to buy it.
Shout out to my girl Chelsea, man, the Black Scholastic on Instagram. She actually put these together and ordered them and everything and like so you like, yo, you need to get these. And I'm like, okay, yeah. So
bro, I ain't even got this. You gotta wait. Yeah. You gotta wait, bro.
But you know, we about to.
This bucket has season, bro.
We're about to have
drop the link where it might be.
Innerpeaceoutofglow.com. Innerpeaceoutofglow.com. InnerpeaceOutofglow.com.
Now, in the meantime, tell them what they need to be listening to.
Well, my last project, Freedom Summer, is out right now. It's on all platforms. That boy Tyler Chronicles just walked in the building, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's not his name. His name is Trapkevious.
But yeah, man, so, you know, shout out to all the movers and shakers.
The shakers and the movers.
The shakers and
the movers. The crooks and the motherfuckers.
Yeah, man. It's all about it. We all about it. Boy, 85 South Show, man, y'all. Love what y'all doing, man.
We're creating Black excellence, bro.
I remember when me and Greg came and did your show, remember? And we started talking about, like, conspiracy stuff. And then remember that thing fell? Yeah, I remember.
It was in there. That? Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, it was crazy, bro.
Hell yeah. Ain't nothing gonna fall today.
Okay.
You got PTSD from that?
Yeah, man. But see, just how far you... Bro, I love what y'all doing, man.
Bro.
My cousins be hitting me up, like, you know, Carlos, man, like...
They don't believe me.
Man, I got some family that's, you know, just from the country. So, like, they see
me
a bunch
too.
Of people from, like, from the gram. So, it's like, you know.
Sometimes I answer phone calls and it just be people on the other end telling them, hey, man, you is my cousin. Tell her,
yeah, right.
And those exact words. Dude. You is my cousin.
Yeah. Cause man, people love like a lot of times, especially when you in these remote places, like that's all you got, you know what I mean?
I know. I be in them remote places too.
Yeah.
Sometimes I just go to random places just to fuck people up. I'm like,
what you doing?
The chicken circuit, bro.
Man.
They love you forever though.
Yeah, man.
Like whenever I start seeing you go and sell out in them niche places, that's why I'm like, oh yeah, he good forever. He good forever. Like, yeah, like you can go do the New York to LA, but everybody can't go do Savannah, Huntsville, Alabama. You know what I'm saying? That's the places where you got to be.
Nashville and all of those.
Make some noise for that.
Yeah, man.
Make some noise, man.
Well, look, man.
Yeah.
This ain't about me. It's all about inner peace, outer glow.
Yeah.
And, you know, I know it's gonna be successful for you because you got grind and hustle, talent, and you a good dude, man. So we're gonna make sure we use our platform to uplift people that we see doing great shit, and we fuck with you over here, and you're always welcome in the trap. 85 South Show, Black Excellence Spotlight, Translee, inner peace, outer glow.
And this you right here, man.
Yeah. Tell somebody that know somebody. Tell somebody that I already got the ones that's gonna hit that hole.